Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I hope you all would be fine and feeling energetic after a weekend and must be waiting for your new English topic for today. So without wasting much time, let's have a start with the topic of the day, and that is your reading comprehension. As you can see on the display, reading comprehension is our topic for today. Now let us see that how many steps are involved in reading comprehension. Like you can see, there is a first step on the screen. You can see step one is do a quick reading of 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, first of all, while you are given the reading paragraph, you are supposed to do a quick reading of only 2 or 3 minutes. Okay, a brief reading. Fine. Once you have done this, then the second step is you have to read through the given questions which are given at the end of the reading paragraph. Once you have done the quick reading of 2 or 3 minutes, then you read through the given questions which are relevant to that reading paragraph. Third step, keeping questions in mind, do extensive and detailed reading of the paragraph. Now all the questions which you have read after the reading of the paragraph, you have to keep them in the mind, because this time in the third step you are doing the detailed or extensive reading of the whole paragraph. Again you are doing the reading, but detailed reading. It means you are trying to understand what is given there, and you are trying to find out the answers also to the questions which are in your mind. Fine. So this is in the third step. In the fourth step, you find the answers to all those questions which are given at the end of the paragraph, and then you write them also on the space which is provided to you on the sheet. Now, important things which you must keep in mind while you are writing the answers to those questions. Number one, you always need to use the same tense which has been used in the questions. For example, if the question is asked into the present tense, likewise you would give the answer into the present tense. If the question has been asked into past tense, the answer would be into the past. Okay, so you have to be careful while writing the answer to the questions that the answer should be in the same tense in which the question has been asked. Now come to the next one. Next point is restate or rephrase half of the question in the answer statements. It means half of the answer you would take from the question itself. This is a point which I would make clear while you would be handling with the reading paragraph. Fine, that how you have to restate the question or rephrase the half of the question while writing the answer to the questions. So these are the points you need to keep in mind, and all those four steps which we discussed in the mind while doing the practice. Now this is your practice time. I am giving you the reading paragraph where you would apply all those four steps, and you would also keep these two important points in your mind while handling that. So please look at your gadget screen. You would right now be looking at that reading paragraph. I hope you all would be able to look at this reading paragraph at your gadget screen. Now you look at this paragraph, please. Read through it, please. This is the reading paragraph which you are supposed to handle, of which questions answers you would write. Look at this. First of all, read through it. And I told you that the first step is to read through it within 2 or 3 minutes. This is what you have to apply. Take the time, 2 or 3 minutes. A very brief look on it. A reading of 2 to 3 minutes, just to give you the idea that what is there in fact into the reading paragraph. Because the detailed reading or the extensive reading you would do later in the third step. This is only your first step. where you are doing two or three minutes quick reading. Yes, read through the questions, that what is asked into the questions. Because reading of the question is also going to help out understand what is there in the reading. It helps you in a great way. I hope you must have done the reading of the questions also. I think there are 5 questions in all. Yes, this is the last one. What is your favorite phase of the moon? Why? This is the last question. So now I hope you have done the quick reading of 2 or 3 minutes. Now, what was the second step? If you just go back, the second step was you were required to do the extensive reading or detailed reading. Fine. It was now you're going to do the extensive and detailed reading. I'm again displaying this reading paragraph before you. This time you do the detailed reading, keeping in mind the questions which you have read through right now at the end of the paragraph. Now do the detailed and extensive reading. Fine. I'm just making it invisible, this reading paragraph, so that the more reading is visible to you. Yes, now you do the detailed reading. Take the time and do the detailed reading and then handle the answer questions. Doing this detailed reading to find the answers to the questions, fine. So keep the questions in the mind and do the reading extensively, with understanding that how you're going to write and what answer you're going to write the questions. Take the time, please, at least 10 minutes to do this reading, so that you are able to handle the questions appropriately in a right way. So Ibrahim has done the reading, good. And how many others have done the reading? Vardha has done. Okay, good. How about the others? If you have done the reading, then take a rough page and start writing the answers to the questions. Okay, let me display the questions before you. Should I display the questions before you? Because many of you have done the reading. How about you, Salim? Have you done? Yes, Subhan, have you done the reading? Michelle? Okay, good. Subhan is done. Sadeen has also done. Ashna has done. Good. Ariba, how about you? Have you done? Good. So I'm going to display the answers now. The questions now. Answers you would write by yourself, not me. Okay. You can see the questions on the display screen. Look at the question number 1. What is meant by a phase of the moon? Okay. What is meant by the phase of the moon? Why does the moon appear to be different sizes? Okay, better if you write the questions on the page on one side and I display the reading before you, reading paragraph before you, so that you are able to write the answers from the reading itself. So you first of all write the questions on the page and then write the answers later when I shall display the reading paragraph before you. Quickly write the questions on one side. What is meant by a phase of the moon? Why does the moon appear to be of different sizes? Third question, what are the 2 phases during which the moon appears almost full but not quite? And then the next question is, what are the 2 phases during which the moon appears only a tiny silver line? So these are the questions. The last one, as for your own opinion, you write the questions and then write the answers. Or listen, you may do the answers later, fine, so that we could handle another topic also, and that is relevant to the picture description. There are certain points which you need to take care of while you are handling with the questions. Fine. First of all, you need to look at the tense which is used into the question. Which tense has been used into the question? Simple present tense. Like you can see, what is meant by a phase of the moon? You can see is mentioned here. Is means this is asked into the simple present tense. So you are going to give the answer into the simple present tense. And the second important point was, you have to rephrase half of the question itself. How you're going to rephrase the question? Like you would writing the answer in this way. What is meant by a phase of the moon? The phase of the moon. You would take the answer from the question itself. The phase of the moon means. Okay, means, not meant. Or you may also write is meant, and then write the answer from the reading paragraph. Fine. And when you're dealing with the second question, why does the moon appear to be different size? Again, it is asked into the simple present tense. Does. Does is the helping verb, which shows that it is asked into the simple present tense. So likewise, the answer would be into the simple present tense. You would write the answer like this. The moon appears, not appear, appears to be of different sizes because, then you would write the answer which you have taken from the reading text. Fine. A reading paragraph. So half of the answer you are taking from the question itself, and the tense you are using is the same that is used into the question itself. Fine. The moon appears to be of different sizes because. And question 3, what are the two phases during which the moon appears almost full but not quite? Here the question is incomplete. I think some words are missing. I shall complete them later. But anyhow, again, it is asked into the simple present tense. So likewise, the answer would be given into the simple present tense. And half of the answer or question you would rephrase. While writing the answer, you would rephrase the question from the question itself. Then, what are the two phases during which the moon appears as only a tiny silver? It is also into the present. So write the answer into the present. And last one, what is your favorite phase of the moon? This is your own opinion. Formatted answer would be here. You have to write your own choice, your own favorite phase of the moon which you like, and why you like it, why you like that phase. Okay, give the answer. Fine. So these are the questions, and you would give their answer into the simple present tense, because all the questions are asked into the simple present tense, and rephrase the answers, rephrase the questions while writing the answer to this question. So this was about your reading comprehension paragraph. I hope the things would be clear to you now, and you would do them in the best way possible. Once you have written the answer to all these questions, share your answers, images with me. Fine. Don't forget to do it, please. This is your task for today. This comprehension paragraph is your task for today, and complete it today. Fine. This is the only task which I am assigning you for today.